Hi there, I'm Natasha Groblewski. I'm the owner of Barre3 in Bedford. Barre3 is all about making it your own. I'll offer lots of modifications throughout class. You can watch Kristen for these modifications, or you can also follow Deb, who's gonna be fierce today. All right, you'll need a handheld set of weights. We usually say 1 to 2 pounds, and you'll need a mat. All right, we're gonna get started. So starting off in primary posture, feet right underneath your hips. Soften your knees, pull your belly button up and in, stand up tall. Relax your shoulders. Inhale, reach your hands up, open your chest. Exhale, press through your palms, scoop and round your back. Inhale to lift. Exhale, scoop and round. Just warming up your spine here, connecting with your breath last time. And as you exhale, step your feet into sumo, drawing your hands down to your waist. Press your seat back and down. Drop your right shoulder, gaze over your left elbow. So think about dropping your seat down, keeping your chest lifted, and then maybe use your right hand to open up your right inner thigh. Take a deep breath in, lift up tall, and as you exhale, switch sides. Drop your left shoulder, gaze over your right elbow. Again, maybe using your left hand to open up your left inner thigh. Inhale. And then as you exhale, unwind. We're gonna add some sumo squats. Drop it down, lift tall, lower, lift. So we're just gonna warm up the body in layers here. Prep it for all 30 minutes. Drop, lift, lower, lift tall. Pull your belly in. Option to add your arms. Reach forward, pull back, reach, pull back. Now any knee pain, low back pain, you're gonna stay higher and smaller just like Kristen. Any shoulder pain, hands can come right to your waist. Drop, lift. So remember to breathe and warm up here. Root through your heels. We're warming up your glutes, your thighs, warming up your upper body. All right, we're gonna move into some box lifts. Drop it down, reach tall, lower, lift. Really reaching through your fingertips here. Arms are strong. Any shoulder pain, hands come out in front of your chest. Gorgeous, Kristen. Lift, drop, lift. So really think about sending your seat back and down here. Chest is still lifted. Drop, lift. Keeping your knees stacked right over your ankles to protect your knees. Drop, reach. You've got four more. Three, two, hold it low. Lift your right heel, pivot to the left. Sweep your arms high, crescent lunge, hold. So you're pressing down with your left heel. Left knee is stacked directly over left ankle. Then you're gonna peel your right heel up. Gorgeous, Deb. Really flexing the back of your right leg. So this crescent lunge is active. Opening up your right hip. Drawing your belly in, and then releasing the shoulders down your back. Any shoulder pain, hands come right to heart center here. Just breathe. So feel really strong in this posture here. Take a deep breath in, and then as you exhale, lower your left hand down, reach up and over with your right fingertips for side body lean. So you're really opening up the right side of your body here. Think about lifting up and over. Take one more deep breath here. And then as you exhale, draw your hand back down, come back to center. We're gonna move back to those sumo squats. Drop back, lift, lower, lift up. Just like before, feet are a little bit wider than your hips. Toes are at 11 and 1. Your knees are stacked right over your ankles. Pressing your seat back. Belly's pulled in. Relax your shoulders. Drop, lift. Think about lifting up nice and tall here. Barre3 is a 60-minute, or in this case, 30-minute core workout today. So I want you to be engaging your belly, pulling your belly button in towards your spine. Drop down, lift. All right, let's add a flat palm press. Drop. Press, lower, press. Any shoulder pain, if that does not feel good for you today, you keep your hands right at your waist. Drop, press. And just like before, any knee pain, low back pain, you're gonna work higher, smaller. Drop, lift. So maybe you imagine that you're pulling the air behind you, right in front of you. So arms are strong, pressing that air. Drop. Let's move into a side body lean, lower, reach. Really lengthen through the side of your body. Any shoulder pain, you can come right back to where we were before. Find what feels good in your body today. Our bodies are different every day. So maybe you do this workout once today and once tomorrow. And maybe you take those modifications tomorrow. Drop down, press, reach. We've got eight more here. Eight. Keep breathing. We're already sweating here with you. You've got four, three, two. Hold it low. Lift your left heel. Pivot to the right. Sweep your arms high, finding crescent lunge. Hold. So press down with your right heel. Right knee is stacked directly over right ankle. Gorgeous, Kristen. And then you're peeling your left heel up as much as you can, lengthening through your left leg. Opening up your left hip, belly's pulled in, shoulders are released. Any shoulder pain, just like before, hands can come to heart center. So remember, this is an active stretch. You're really pressing down with your right heel, really flexing the back of your left leg. Take a deep breath here. And then as you exhale, lower your right hand down. Reach up and over with left fingertips for side body lean. Opening up the left side of your body. Think about lifting up and over. Gorgeous, Kristen. Deep breath here. And then as you exhale, lower your hand down, face the center. Bring your feet a little bit wider. Point your toes forward, hands to your waist, wide flat back fold over. Draw your chest parallel to the floor. Lift your hips, finding a nice hamstring release. And if it feels good, maybe you bring your hands down to the floor. Finding your breath. We're about to get that heart rate right back up here. Take a deep breath here. And then as you exhale, soften your knees, roll yourself up, toe heel your feet underneath your hips, chest opener. Draw your hands behind you into cape or interlace your fingers, draw your knuckles down, gaze up, opening up your chest here. I told you, we're sweating here already with you. All right, go ahead and release, grab your weights. You don't need them, but you can use them. We're moving into horse pose. Bring your feet wide. Bend your knees and just hold. So scan your body. Feet are wider than your hips. Toes are at 10 and 2 o'clock. Knees track over the tops of your feet. Now I want you to gaze down. Can you see your big toes? If you can't, you're gonna pull your feet in a little bit closer, work a little higher. Hips are level. Belly pulls up and in. Release your shoulders. Hands are right at your waist here. Drop your seat a little bit lower. Yeah. Feel your inner thighs start to work. Root through your heels. We're gonna add little pulses. Pulse your seat. Down. Pulse. Little pulse. So right away, any knee pain, you're gonna work higher. Any low back pain, or if this just doesn't feel good for you, you can come into sumo, just like where we were in warm-up. Pulse down. Down. Yeah. Gorgeous. So you work as high or as low as you'd like. Belly's pulled in. Working your quads. Working your inner and outer thighs, I know you feel them. Working your postural muscles that help you stand taller here. Pulse down, keep it going, pulse. So think about lifting up through the crown of your head here. Pulse, four, three, we're gonna move big soon. Two, just hold it right here. Firm through your feet, relax your shoulders. Nice and big, drop your seat, down, lift. Lower, lift tall. So any knee pain, you're gonna work smaller and higher, just like Kristen. Drop, lift, or follow Deb and sink it low. Let's add our right arm. Pull, reach, pull back, reach forward. So draw your elbow back behind you and then press your knuckles in front. Pull, reach, working your lats, working your shoulder here. All right, option to add a right leg lift. Drop, lift, lower, reach forward. Is your belly button pulled in? I forgot to pull it in. Drop down, reach. Keep breathing here. Take breaks when you need. You've got 8 more of these. So you'll see Kristen isn't using weights because you do not even need them. You're gonna get a total body, low impact workout even without those weights. 3, 2, hold it low. Lift your right heel. Pivot to the left. Draw your arms long in front. Drop your right knee. This is your carousel horse. Hold right here. So your left knee is stacked directly over left ankle. Your right knee is below right hip. Hips are level. Gorgeous, Deb. Belly pulls in. Release your shoulders. 1-inch movements. Take your right knee down 1 inch. Lift. Lower down. Lift. Now, any shoulder discomfort, hands come to your waist. Burning up your quads right now. Any knee pain, you're gonna work higher. Really press down with your left heel. Yeah, how you doing, Kristen? Yeah, we're feeling it over here. Lower down, lift, keep breathing. Drop down, lift. All right, you guys, you got 4 more. 4, 3, 2, hold it low, just hold. Draw your belly in, relax your shoulders. Working your shoulders already. We're gonna move nice and big. Here we go. Lift, pull your elbows back, reach. Lift, pull them back, reach. So you're gonna flip your palms here. Then reach it forward one more slow. Lift. Let's catch that beat. Pull, drop, lift, lower. Working your quads. Working your biceps. Lift. Drop, work on your shoulders. And you're working your lats as you pull your elbows back. So really pull them back. Pull back, reach forward. Option to stay here. Option to add a right leg lift. Lift, drop down. Just an option, never a challenge. Drop down. All right, so one of my favorite things about barre3 is that you rev your heart rate up and we get in our cardio. So I never feel like I have to go for a run afterwards. Having that cardio section in class is really good for your heart, good for your mind, and revs your metabolism for the other 23 hours of your day. You've got 8, 7, drop. Keep breathing for 4, 3, 2, hold it up, hold right here. Yeah, find your balance. Drop your chest, reach your arms long behind you, finding warrior 3. Tricep pulses, pulse it up 1 inch, little lift. All right, any discomfort with that foot lifted? You keep it connected just like Kristen here. In tricep pulses, it's all about how much you reach through your knuckles here. Arm is straight, arm is lengthened. Little lift. Pull your belly in. You're almost done with side one. For 8, 7, 6. Can you drop your chest 1 more inch? I hope you can see the sweat dripping off of us. 3, 2, just hold. Hold right here. Pull your belly in. Reach through your toes. Take a deep breath. And then as you exhale, come back to center, back to horse pose. Bend your knees, hands at your waist. Relax your shoulders. Take a deep breath. We're gonna find those little pulses. Pulse to your seat, down, down. Yeah, so again, we're working our inner thighs, working our outer thighs, working our quads. We are working everything here right now. Tiny, tiny. 8 more small. Really root through your heels, root through the outsides of your feet. For 4, in 3, we're gonna move big. 2, hold right here, let's move big, drop it down, lift. Really bend your knees, extend your legs. Drop, lift. Remember, you can work higher and smaller if that feels better. All right, we're gonna add our left arm right here, pull it back, reach. pull back, reach forward. Remember, you can drop your weights at any point. Wrap your elbow around your rib cage, press through your knuckles, pull, reach. Option to add your left leg lift, drop, lift. Just an option. If you're lifting that left leg, I want you to focus on really pressing through your right leg to lift you up here. Drop, lift. Eight more. Pull your belly in. You've got four, three, two, hold it low, hold right here, lift your left heel, pivot to the right, drop your knee down, reach your arms in front, hold. So now right knee is stacked over right ankle, and then your left knee is stacked below left hip, hips are level, belly pulls in, release your shoulders, 1-inch movements, take it down an inch, lift, lower down, lift up. So arms are lengthened in front to work your shoulders, or bring your hands right to your waist if that feels better. Drop down, lift. You've got eight more small. Seven, then remember, we're gonna move big just like before. For four, three, two, hold right here. Let's move big. So lift for two, drop for two. Lift, pull your elbows back, drop, reach through your knuckles, lift. Belly button's pulled in here, lift. All right, let's catch that beat. So pull, drop. You might feel a little unstable here. I feel unstable. Your body's working like crazy to keep you stable. So all those little muscles are working here. Pull, drop. Option to add your left leg lift. Lift, drop, lift. Drop down. You've got four, three, two. Hold it at the top, hold right here. Draw your chest down, reach your arms long behind you. Finding tricep pulses. Little lift, little lift, little lift. Woo! Yeah, you can probably see I'm shaking like crazy here. Little lift, little lift. Remember, you're reaching through your knuckles, releasing your shoulders, widen down your back. Little lift. This is gorgeous, Deborah. Lift. Burning out your triceps here. Finish strong. You've got eight, then we're moving it to the mat. Seven. Can you drop your chest any lower? Embrace that instability for four, three, two. Just hold right here, take a deep breath. And then as you exhale, come on up, come on out onto your mat for all fours. Place your weights off to the side. Bring your hands below your shoulders, knees below hips. Lift your left knee and just hold. All right, so splay your hands open here. Wrists are stacked directly below shoulders. Release your shoulders, widen down your back, gorgeous. Belly pulls in, hips stay level here. Our tendency is to start to open up this left hip, so I want you to really intentionally keep it low. Then go ahead and reach through your right knee, yes. Root your left knee, root through your right shin here. Just hold, we're gonna add little taps here. So tap your toes, up an inch, little lift. All right away. If this doesn't feel good on your wrists, you're gonna come down on your forearms. And if this just doesn't feel good down on the floor, you come right to standing just like Kristen here. Softening your standing leg and tapping your toes back. So we're working the left central glute muscle here and our hamstrings. We're working our core. And you're working your upper body here like crazy to keep you upright. Little lift, yeah. Think about pulling your heel towards your seat to activate your hamstring. And then really reach through your knee to get into your glute here. Little lift. So we're focusing on that left glute, but you guys, you're gonna start to feel it in that left side, in your right side, your standing hip here. Because your tiny little stabilizer muscles are working like crazy to keep you balanced. Little lift, you've got eight more small. Then we're gonna flush it out. Six, 5, keep breathing. I hope you guys can see my mat. It is drenched in sweat. For 3, 2, just hold. Hold right here. Relax your shoulders. Draw your belly in. Root through your right shin. Can you pull your heel a little bit closer to your seat? Maybe you can see me shaking. Maybe lift your left heel, your left knee a little bit more. Nice and big. Drop your left knee down for 2. Press up for 2. Lower down. Lift up. So lengthening your glute and then contracting it. Drop. All right, option to catch that beat. Drop it down, lift, lower, press up, drop, lift. Yeah, gorgeous, Kristen. Pull, press up. You're almost there with the side. You've got 4, 3, 2, last one, hold it up, hold right here. So we're gonna get into the side of the seat now. Go ahead and draw your left knee out to the left, opening up your glute, and then pull your knee back in line with your hip. All right, we're gonna move a little bit faster here. Let's catch that beat. Take it out, pull in, press out, pull in. So we were working the central glute muscles and the hamstrings before. Now we're working the side of the seat. So why do we work our glutes, right? We're working our glutes to help us stand taller, to help us move with more ease throughout our day, and to help balance out our bodies. So most of us have pretty weak glutes, so we're counteracting all of that right here, strengthening them to help prevent low back pain. Pull in, press out, press, pull. Just a few more here. 3, 2, last one, hold it in, just hold. Here's your grand finale where you're gonna seal the deal on all that work you just did. Option to reach and lengthen through right fingertips. Think about reaching through those fingertips and reaching through your knee. Can you give me 1 more inch? Maybe lift them 1 inch higher. For 4, 3, 2, lower down, gorgeous. Switch sides, lift your right knee, hold right here. So hands are still below shoulders. Relax your shoulders down your back. Belly pulls in. Reach through your right knee and then keep your hips level here. Belly button's pulled in. Really root through your left shin. We're gonna start with that 1 inch movement here. So tap your toes, up an inch, little lift, little lift. Again, think about pulling your heel towards your seat to activate your hamstring. Little lift. Little lift. Finding that long line from the crown of your head all the way through your knee. Little lift, little lift. Take breaks when you need here. Little lift. You've got 4, 3, remember we're gonna move big soon. 2, just hold, hold right here. Are your hips level? Is your belly pulled in? Can you pull your heel a little bit closer to your seat? All right, we're gonna move big to that 2 count. Pull it in for 2. Press up, reach through your knee. Pull in, press back. Pull in, press back. So what I love about barre3 is that it's total body and low impact here. You're gonna find those results. We recommend normally that people come 3 or more times a week to really see and feel those changes in their body. And the other great part is that you're never gonna see the same workout over and over again. We have tons of different moves, lots of different music. You're never gonna get bored. You're never gonna plateau. Pull in, press up. Press, pull. All right, option to catch that beat here. Drop down, lift, lower, lift, pull, press. We're just gonna do 8 more. 8, 7. Then we've got those levers coming up. For 4, 3, 2. Last one, hold it up. Take your knee out, pull it in. 2 more slow, press. Pull in, press, and then pull it in. Just hold right here. Draw your belly in. We're going to catch that bead here. Work in our side seat. Take it out. Pull. Press out. Pull in. Yeah. So remember to keep those hips level. Maybe you imagine that you're a dog with a fire hydrant. You're just lifting your leg out and then pull in. Keep your hips so stable though. You've got 8. This is how we finish seat work. For 6. Pull your heel a little bit closer to your seat. You got this. 3, 2, last one. Hold it in. Grand finale hold. Option to reach and lengthen through left fingertips. And then I want you to give me 1 inch. Maybe you reach a little bit more. Maybe you pull your belly in. Maybe you lift 1 inch higher. For 4, 3, 2, lower down. All right, we're moving right into core work here. Coming into flat back core. So come all the way down onto your spine. All right, and then go ahead and lift one leg up into tabletop and then the other. Hold right here. So you're pulling your belly button in towards your spine without pressing your low back against the mat. Hips are heavy in the mat, knees are stacked over your hips. Relax your shoulders here, hands down to a low V. Inhale, reach your right leg long, and then as you exhale, draw the knee back over your hip. Gorgeous, Deb. Inhale, reach your left leg long, and then exhale, pull it back over the hip. Option to stay nice and slow, or option to start to catch that beat. So reach, reach, reach. Working your transverse abdominals here that help protect your inner organs and help you stand taller. Breathe with more ease. So any low back pain, you're gonna follow Kristen here and draw your toes higher toward the sky here. Reach, reach. Maybe you work slower if that feels better for your body and you feel like you can get a little deeper. This is all about you, so find what feels good in your body today. Option to stay right here, or option to draw your hands behind your head and maybe lift your head and shoulders. Maybe you find a twist, so twist, twist. Drawing your shoulder toward the opposite knee. Reach, reach. So if you lifted your head and shoulders, you're now engaging your rectus abdominals. Those are your six-pack abs. Finding that twist like Deb, you're working your obliques as well. Those are your side abdominal muscles. So this is total efficiency. At Barre3, we are all about efficiency and giving you the most bang for your buck here in terms of your time. We know you don't have hours to work out, so we're gonna give you efficient moves here. Total body. Reach, reach. Keep pulling your belly in. And I want you to imagine that through the camera, I'm gonna come and I'm gonna poke you in the belly button. And you're gonna pull your belly button away, right? Because no one likes to be poked in the belly button. That's the contraction that I want you to have the whole time. Reach, reach. Keep breathing. Press. You're almost done here. You've got 8, 7 more each side. Then we're gonna find a grand finale hold. 4, 3, 2, hold at this side, just hold. Can you pull your belly button any more toward your spine? Can you draw your knee any more towards your face? Maybe lower your lengthened leg 1 more inch. Just breathe. For 4, allow your belly to shake. 3, 2, inhale, reach the opposite toes long, draw the opposite shoulder towards your knee, pull your belly down, pull your knee towards your face, maybe lower your lengthened leg 1 more inch. For 4, 3, 2, lower down. Beautiful job. All right, go ahead and press yourself up or rock and roll your way up. We're moving into a final plank here. So come on down onto your belly. Face your mat. Plant your palms on your mat right below your shoulders. Step your feet back and just hold. So right away, any wrist discomfort, you come down on your forearms. And if this is just too much resistance for you, lower your knees just like Kristen here. You're still working like crazy. Wrists are stacked below shoulders. Release your shoulders, widen down your back. Think about pressing away from your mat here. Collarbone is wide. Belly pulls in, and then you're reaching through your heels here. Gorgeous, Deborah. Total body. You're working like crazy here. Breathe, pull your belly in, and press away from your mat. You're more than halfway there. Option to add a baby knee bend. Bend your right knee, your left knee. Bend, bend. Just an option, it is never a challenge. Working your obliques, keeping your hips so steady. Bend one knee, the other. You've got 8, 7. For 4, 3, 2, last one. Take a deep breath here. And then as you exhale, lower your knees. Bring your knees wide. Press your seat back and down. Find child's pose. If it feels better, you can draw your hands by your sides, releasing your shoulders a little bit. Think about really pressing your hips back, releasing your inner thigh, releasing your glutes. Slowly walk your hands over to the left. Press into your right hip and reach through your right fingertips as much as you can, opening up the right side of your body here. This should feel good. And then slowly walk your hands back to the center and over to the right, pressing into your left hip and reaching through your left fingertips as much as possible. Now opening up left side of your body. Slowing down your breath here. And slowly draw yourself back to center. Press yourself up, moving into low crouch. Draw your toes under, press your weight back into your feet. Chest is at your thighs, and then tuck your chin to your chest. Any discomfort here, you can pop up into umpire's pose. Whatever feels good in your body. If you're in low crouch, pulling your heels down toward the mat, tucking your chin in towards your chest to release the back of your neck. Inhale, fill your belly with air, and as you exhale, dive your tailbone up toward the sky. Finding a nice flat back fold over here, or fold over, excuse me. Upper body just falls toward the mat, and if it feels good, you can also soften your knees. Just finding a nice hamstring stretch. Maybe you sway back and forth. Maybe you grab hold of opposite elbows. Just finding what your body needs in this moment. Allowing yourself all of these 30 minutes just for you. Come back to center. Inhale, fill your belly with air. And as you exhale, roll up as slowly as you possibly can. Let's finish with one closing breath. Inhale, reach your hands up toward the sky. Bring your hands to heart center as you exhale. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. This has been such a pleasure.